Major funding for the production of Granite State Challenge has been provided by Unitil, Energy for Life, NEA New Hampshire, with additional funding from D.F. Richard, Markham Image, Heinemann Publishing, Measured Progress, the NEEF Networks for College Planning, and by viewers like you. Thank you.
Get ready. It's time for New Hampshire high schools to match wits in a high-stakes scholastic showdown. It's time for Granite State Challenge. Here's your host, Jim Janot.
And hi, everybody, and welcome to another game of Granite State Challenge as we head into the home stretch of our season. We are down to our final four, two semifinals coming right up. The season beginning back in November. There's some 52 high schools around the state. Final four, each of the two teams playing tonight have already won two games. They look for a win tonight that will move them into our Super Challenge. Let's introduce you to the two teams playing in tonight's semifinal round game. First of all, we have the team from Bishop Guertin High School. Bishop Guertin, with an enrollment of some 800 students, is located in Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm Tim, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Zach, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Dave, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Holly, and I'm a freshman.
The team is coached by Lisa LaRochelle. Her alternates are Isaiah Sirwa and David McCallie. They are the Cardinals of Bishop Guertin High School. All right, that's our first team playing. Now let's introduce you to their opponents for tonight's semifinal. This is the team from Concord High School. Concord High, with an enrollment of about 1,780 students, is located in Merrimack County.
Hi, I'm Oswald. I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Elliot. I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Joe. I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Annika. I'm a senior.
With us for the program, the coaches for the team, Helen Dugan and Chad Fleming, and they are the Crimson Tide of Concord High School. Our last introduction is to let you know who our judges are. Once again, we welcome back Ann Belanger and Jim Johnston. All right, introductions are out of the way. Let's play the game as we are into our final four, first semifinal round game. We play just the same as we have all season long. We'll have 10-point toss-ups, a bonus round, and a 60-second round that we'll talk about a little bit later on. All right, let's get on with the game. Bishop Guertin, Concord, good luck. Here we go. This singer's debut album, Kate Hudson, was released in 2001 and featured Christian rock. Tim of Guertin.
Alicia Keys.
Good try. Concord. It was Katy Perry. Actor Martin Sheen played the character Jed Bartlett in the TV series In the West Wing. Tim of Bishop Guertin.
New Hampshire.
I can repeat it for Concord. Actor Martin Sheen played the character Jed Bartlett in the TV series The West Wing. His character is a direct descendant of this New Hampshire delegate to the Continental Congress. Elliot?
Josiah Bartlett.
Josiah Bartlett is correct. On July 21st, 1969, Neil Armstrong, as part of this NASA mission, Tim of Bishop Guertin,
Apollo 11,
became the first person to walk on the moon as part of Apollo 11. A portrait of Cosette by artist Emile Bayard was found in the first edition of this novel by Victor Hugo. Holly of Bishop Guertin.
Les Miserables.
Les Miserables is correct. In 1638, Swedish colonists set up a trading post they called New Sweden on land that is now part of this state. Elliot of Concord.
Pennsylvania.
Bishop Guertin. Tim.
New York.
You're both in the general area, but it was Delaware. This river, which flows from Tibet to the East China Sea, is the deepest river in the world, Tim of Guertin.
The Yangtze.
The Yangtze, as deep as 500 feet in some places. Express the decimal 0.75 as a fraction in lowest terms, Tim of Guertin.
Three-fourths.
Three-fourths is correct. This Danish philosopher published what some consider his most important work, Tim of Bishop Guertin.
Kierkegaard.
Kierkegaard is correct, his most important work, either or. And I'll go on with the question some other show. We'll save it for next year. We only read half of it. This widely respected network anchor ended every newscast with the phrase, Elliot of Concord.
Walter Cronkite.
And that's the way it is. Walter Cronkite is correct. The musical Evita was about this first lady of Argentina, Tim of Bishop Guertin.
Eva Perón.
Eva Perón is right. This novel by Margaret Mitchell won the Pulitzer Prize, Tim of Bishop Guertin.
Gone with the Wind.
Gone with the Wind is also correct. 146 garment workers were killed in a fire, Elliot of Concord.
A triangle shirtwaist fire.
You got it. In this New York City factory in 1911, Triangle Shirtwaist Factory is correct. Although best known for his movies about the mafia, this director also was the screenwriter and director for Apocalypse Now, Tim of Guertin.
Francis Ford Coppola.
Correct. Although Woodrow Wilson came up with the idea for this international group, Aswad of Concord.
League of Nations.
The League of Nations, after World War I, the United States did not join the organization. On May 6, 1882, President Chester Arthur signed a law placing a 10-year moratorium on immigration on any worker, Aswad of Concord.
China.
From this country. China is correct. Another 10-point toss-up coming up now. In 1919, eight players from this team were banned, Tim of Guertin.
The White Sox.
The Chicago White Sox, a baseball scandal. Right, we have a picture photo for you to look at. Take a look at the photo and we'll ask the question. This physicist first made his mark when he launched a powder rocket in the basement. Tim of Bishop Guertin.
Goddard.
Robert Goddard is correct. This baseball player was known as Jolting Joe and the Yankee Clipper, Tim of Guertin.
Joe DiMaggio.
Joe DiMaggio is right. After he split with the Republican Party, Theodore Roosevelt formed the Progressive Party, Elliot of Concord.
Bull Moose Party.
Which was better known by this name. Bull Moose Party is right. Pulling it out of the fire, well done. This section of the throat extends from the nasal cavities to the larynx. Tim of Guertin.
The esophagus.
Concord. Joe.
The mouth.
It is the pharynx, specifically. A Ben & Jerry's cherry-flavored ice cream gets its name, Elliot of Concord.
Jerry Garcia.
Who from this man, the lead singer and guitarist from The Grateful Dead, Jerry Garcia, ice cream is correct. Director John Landis is known for films like The Blues Brothers, An American Werewolf in London, and the video for Michael Jackson's Thriller. He also directed this film based on writer Chris Miller's experiences at Dartmouth College in Hanover. Elliot of Concord.
Animal House.
Animal House is correct. Certain types of white blood cells play crucial roles in the body's immune response. What is the name for the white blood cells that are produced by bone marrow? Aswad of Concord.
Lymphocytes.
Lymphocytes is right. This pediatrician's book, Baby and Child Care, Tim of Bishop Guertin.
Dr. Spock.
Dr. Spock, first published back in 1946. Actress Gabori Sarabi was nominated for Tim of Bishop Guertin.
Precious.
For her role as Clarice Jones in this 2009 movie. Precious is right. The hymn Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee was written to the melody of Ode to Joy from the final movement of this symphony. Tim of Guertin.
Beethoven's Ninth Symphony.
Judges, you'll take that? Yeah. By Beethoven. The answer was Ninth Symphony, but you said Beethoven's Ninth. You are correct. This work by Scottish author J.M. Barrie was written first as a play, Tim of Guertin.
Peter Pan.
Peter Pan, back in 1904. All right, one more photo for you to look at, and we'll ask the question. This Frankish king is often referred to, Elliot of Concord.
Charlemagne.
Charlemagne is also referred to as the father of Europe. This hip-hop group that formed in 1981 in New York City featured Mike D. Diamond, Adam MCA Yock, and Adam Ad Rock Horowitz, and was originally a punk band, Elliot of Concord.
The Beastie Boys.
The Beastie Boys is right on the money. And there's the sound ending our round in a very high-scoring opening round, as it would be expected in our semifinals. Bishop Guertin getting a little bit of a lead after round number one by a score of 150 to 100. We got the big bonus round, though, right around the corner. Before we get there, let's ask Lori Warner to join us, as she has done all season long. I will correct the score. Now we see that the score is 150 to 110. Keep that thought in mind as we look at Lori talking with the captain from Bishop Guertin High School.
Why, thank you, Jim. And we're here with the captain of the Guertin team, Tim Morrison. Now, you're a veteran at this.
Yes, this is my second year, so it's exciting to be back.
It is. And this year, of course, you're a junior, so that means?
That means we'll hopefully be back next year for one more very exciting year.
It is. It really is. Now, speaking of exciting, your team has been to a lot of tournaments. You've traveled all around. Tell me about some of them.
Yeah, this year we've been able to go to some more regional tournaments. So we've been to MIT, Harvard. We went to another one in Massachusetts, another one in Connecticut. We're hoping to maybe squeeze out one or two more throughout the year. So that's good.
Especially after you win, right?
Yes. Well, we'll see. We're getting there. Not quite there yet, but we're hoping to.
What do you do for preparation for these matches?
Well, we practice once a week for about an hour after school. And I know a lot of us do some independent stuff. We all love the show Jeopardy. Of course, who doesn't? So it's a lot of practice, but it's a lot of fun, too.
And then as far as personal matters, you know, you're a reader.
Yeah, I really love to read. I like doing the classics. I'm a big fan of Kurt Vonnegut, the author. Catch-22 is another one of my favorites. I really love satire in general.
Hence the Stephen Colbert reference.
Yes, I am also a huge Stephen Colbert fan.
He is pretty funny. He really is. So now, as far as your coaches, what is it that you'd like to say to your coaches?
Well, our new coach, Miss Laura Schell, she stepped in this year, so we really appreciate that. Our coach from last year, Miss Davidson, took a year off to get her master's degree, but she's still very much involved, and so we appreciate that, too. So it's great to have two very involved people.
It really is, and it's great that you guys are still, I mean, for the most part, a young team, so we're expecting most of them to be back next year.
Yeah, definitely. We hope so.
Well, we wish you the best of luck. It's time for us to head back into the studio and over to you, Jim.
All right, thank you very much to Captain Tim and his team from Bishop Guertin, right now holding on to a little bit of a lead after a high-scoring first period, and that is a 150 to 110 score. Second round is our bonus round. 10-point toss-up questions remain the same, and then the team that identifies it correctly has a chance at bonus points. So here we go, Guertin and Concord for 10 points. Very quickly, what is 30% more than 30? Tim of Guertin.
39
is correct for the 10 points. So over to Guertin we go. And Tim, you're the team captain. I do take your answer for the team, but you can talk to them. Right now, talk to them and choose a category from busy as a beaver, body parts, or funny pages. Busy as a beaver, body parts, or funny pages.
Can we have busy as a beaver, please?
Let's go with busy as a beaver. And again, Tim, after talking to everybody, I do take your answer for the team. Identify the following related to the word beaver. Title of a sitcom that aired in the 50s and 60s featuring Beaver and Wally Cleaver.
Leave it to Beaver.
Leave it to Beaver. You could call someone who is enthusiastic about a task this.
Eager Beaver.
Eager Beaver. Tim the Beaver is the mascot of this university in Cambridge, known for science and technology.
MIT.
MIT is a right for the 15 out of 15. Here we go, teams, with a toss-up. In 1901, this German physicist won the first Nobel Prize in physics. Tim of Guertin.
Röntgen.
Röntgen is correct for the 10 points. So back to you, Tim, for choosing from body parts, funny pages, or up front. Body parts, funny pages, or up front.
Can we have funny pages, please?
You can have the funny pages. Absolutely. Here we go for 5 points apiece. Identify the following cartoonist. He created The Simpsons.
Matt Groening.
Correct. This cartoonist and animator based his most famous character on a pet mouse.
Walt Disney.
Correct. This cartoonist won a Pulitzer for his Doonesbury comic strip.
Trudeau.
Trudeau. Gary Trudeau is right. 15 out of 15. Here's your next 10-point toss-up. In 1841, he became the first U.S. president to die in office. Tim of Bishop Guertin.
William Henry Harrison.
William Henry Harrison is right. So we go back to you, Guertin, for body parts for up front, and we're going to add, what's my number? Body parts, up front, what's my number?
Can we have up front, please?
Let's go with up front. I am going to give you 3 words. Give me the one word you can add to the front of each of these words to create a new word. Here we go. The 3 words are flower, spot, screen.
Sun.
Correct. Fly, cracker, place. And we're looking for fire, for firefly, firecracker. Here's your next one. Fall, color, melon.
Water.
Water. 10 out of 15 on the bonus. Here we go with a 10-pointer. In 1970, four students were killed by the National Guard, Tim of Bishop Guertin.
Kent State.
At Kent State in Ohio while they were protesting the U.S. invasion of Cambodia. Well, back to Guertin we go. We still have our body parts. We've got what's my number, and then we got GEO caching.
Can we have what's my number, please?
Let's go with what's my number. We want you to identify the following famous numbers. 3.14 is also known by this tasty name.
Hi.
Correct. This name for one followed by 100 zeros was the inspiration for the name of something you probably use every day.
Google.
Correct. According to a song by the band Three Dog Night, this is the loneliest number.
One.
One is the loneliest number. All right, here we go. No, we go. There's our sound ending the round. Well, Bishop Guertin, needless to say, took advantage of round number two to open things up halfway through the game. 245 to 110 with our 60-second round coming right up. Before we get there, though, we now take a timeout. Ask Lori to rejoin us, this time talking with Team Captain Aswad from Concord High School.
And thank you, Jim. We are talking to Aswad Iqbal. Now, you are the captain of the team.
Yep. This is our first time coming to the semifinals, so we're really happy to be here.
Yeah, we're very excited to have you here, too. Now, as a team, you guys have worked really hard. What are some of the things that you've done to prepare for this?
Yeah, we've been working on the buzzer. We've been doing a lot of questions. We've also been watching matches to kind of see how the game works and what kind of questions are asked. So a lot of practice that way.
Do you do things like watch Jeopardy? The other team does.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We watch Jeopardy at home and stuff. Yeah, we do a lot of things.
I find that the questions on this show are actually harder than on Jeopardy, don't you think?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, it definitely can be. Yeah.
That might be a career path, then. You could just do the circuit of the game shows where you actually have to be smart and make some money that way.
That would be nice, yeah, yeah.
Now, speaking of that, you know, personal things that you like to do, super chill, and you like hip-hop.
Yeah, yeah. Everyone seems to think I like classical music, but I like my gangster rap, so, you know.
Why would you like classical music?
I don't know. Everyone's like, oh, it's a smart kid. He must like classical music. So, you know.
Yeah, enough of that stereotyping. Down with the stereotypes. But what are some of your favorite groups?
I like Outkast, Kanye. Yeah. If you want to go back, going to like Tribe Called Quest, stuff like that. Yeah.
Even some of the classic hip hop. All right, cool. I like that stuff too. So as far as what you're going to do if you win, is there anything you'd like to say to the coaches or, you know, the principal about perhaps getting a day off, getting it declared the Granite State Challenge Team Day?
Any of those things would be great, but right now we're just focused on actually winning. So, you know, just trying to get there first.
Well, we wish you the best of luck with that, Aqua. And we are going to wrap things up and get back to the studio with you, Jim.
All right, Lori, thank you very much. You see Aswad and his teammates up there right now, halfway through the game, needing a comeback in the second half of the show. They're going to try to start that right here in the third round. It's our 60-second round. We ask 10 points in 60 seconds. Give them 10 points for every correct answer. Bonus them 10 if they get them all right in under a minute. All right, Aswad, your team is trailing, so you can talk to everybody and choose from these categories. Glass menagerie, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'd like to buy a vowel. Glass menagerie, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay.
I'd like
one, two, to buy three, a four, vowel. Please.
Say again, 1, 2, 3, 4?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Aswad, again, as team captain, I take your answer, but you can talk to everybody. We want you to identify the following books with numbers in their titles. Start the clock. Dickens novel set in London and Paris.
A Tale of Two Cities.
Correct. Rhyming book from Dr. Seuss with a colorful title.
One fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish.
Correct. Kurt Vonnegut novel featuring Billy
Pilgrim. Catch 22.
Say again.
Catch 22.
It's Slaughterhouse 5. Ken Kesey novel set in an Oregon psychiatric hospital.
One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
Correct. Nathaniel Hawthorne book inspired by a house in Salem, Massachusetts.
Pass.
Alexander Dumas' novel about the adventure of
that.
Correct. The second volume of the Lord of the Rings trilogy.
The Two Towers.
Correct. Novel by Jan Martel about a boy who was stranded.
Life of Pi.
Correct. Novel by Joseph Heller that follows Captain John Yossarian.
Catch 22.
Correct. Jules Verne novel about Captain Nemo.
20,000 Leagues Under the Sea.
Correct. Judges? They did well after a little slow start, came right back and wrapped them up at the end, getting 8 out of 10 on their 62nd round. So 80 points onto the scoreboard for Concord. And over to Bishop Guertin we go. You have your alternates there, Tim. Everybody ready to play. Choose from Glass Menagerie or I'd Like to Buy a Vowel.
Can we have Glass Menagerie, please?
Let's go with that for 10 points apiece. And again, you have everybody up there, including your alternates. But I take your answer for the team. The answers to the following will all contain the word glass. Start the clock. The term for a barrier that keeps women from advancing.
Glass ceiling.
Correct. People in these shouldn't throw rocks.
Glass houses.
Correct. Footwear for Cinderella.
Glass slipper.
Correct. This is the largest city in Scotland.
Glasgow.
Correct. Sherlock Holmes used one of these to examine evidence.
Magnifying glass.
Correct. Contemporary minimalist American composer.
Glass.
Correct. Policy in the former Soviet Union that called for more transparency.
Glasnost.
Say again.
Glasnost.
Correct. The U.S. Banking Act of 1933 is more commonly known as this.
Pass.
The artist Matisse worked in this medium that you often find in cathedrals.
Stained glass.
Correct. He hosts the public radio show This American Life.
Hourglass.
Correct. And you missed our glass steagle. 9 out of 10 on their 62nd round. Well done. 90 points onto the scoreboard for Bishop Guertin High School. And our score at the end of three now. Bishop Guertin in front, 335 to 190. Now we go into our fourth and final round teams. One change in this round, and that's to remind you that if you get the answer incorrect, 10 points will be deducted from your team's score. Other than that, everything's a go. Let's go with 10 points. In 2005, it was revealed that Mark Felt, former associate director of the FBI, Tim of Bishop Guertin,
Deep Throat,
was this Watergate informant. Deep Throat is right. This 14th century Italian poet, often referred to as the father of humanism, Tim of Bishop Guertin,
Petrarch.
Petrarch is right. This English actor is known for playing roles like Sherlock Holmes, David of Bishop Guertin. I can repeat it for Concord, but I won't. Aswad?
Benedict Cumberbatch.
Yeah, it is. Benedict Cumberbatch is correct. In 1969, this woman, I'm going to start it again. In 1969, this woman known as the Iron Lady of Israel, Tim of Bishop Guertin,
Golda Meir,
became the first and to this point only female prime minister of Israel. That is correct. About 2.5 minutes to go in our game. Robert Cook claimed he reached the geographic North Pole in 2008. This man said he was first to reach the geographic North Pole in 2000. Let me do it again. Robert Cook claimed he reached the geographic North Pole in 1908. This man said he was first to reach the geographic North Pole in 1909. I understand. I butchered the question anyway. Robert Peary is the answer we were looking for. President Bill Clinton ordered the selective availability of this now common location tool developed by the U.S. Department of Defense, Elliot of Concord.
GPS.
GPS is correct. A letter from physicist Albert Einstein and Leo Szilard to Franklin Roosevelt in 1939 was one of the factors that led to this research and development venture, Tim of Guertin.
The Manhattan Project.
The Manhattan Project is correct. Which two-digit perfect square has the greatest number of factors? Aswad of Concord.
64.
Bishop Guertin. Tim?
36.
36 is correct. In the tales of Robin Hood, Robin is a supporter of this English king who conquered Cyprus, Elliot of Concord.
Richard the Lionheart?
Richard the Lionhearted is correct. This English writer worked 9 years on a dictionary of the English language, Aswad of Concord.
Webster.
I can repeat it for Guertin. This English writer worked 9 years on a dictionary of the English language, which was published in 1755. Tim?
Johnson.
Samuel Johnson is right. This singer, known as the Godfather of Soul, Tim of Guertin?
James Brown.
James Brown is right. The sinking of this British ocean liner, Tim of Guertin?
The Lusitania.
Is correct. This pitcher, is that enough? This pitcher started his career in 1890 with the Cleveland Spiders. He also played for the St. Louis Perfectos, the Boston Americans, which became the Red Sox, the Elliott of Concord.
Cy Young.
Cy Young is well done. Let's skip the next one, judges. In 1936, this monarch abdicated his throne to marry Elliott of Concord.
Edward.
More.
King Edward.
More.
King Edward the I don't know what his eighth.
Eighth is right. Get it in time. Give him the 10 points. Just as the buzzer sounds ending the game, he worked hard for those 10 points. There's our final score. It'll be Bishop Guertin advancing into our Super Challenge, a well-played game tonight, 405 to 220 over the Crimson Tide of Concord High School. Well played, both teams. For Concord, hope it was fun. Congratulations on your first two wins during the season. Now we do it all over again next week. Semifinal round game number two will pit the Little Green of Manchester Central against the Astros of Pinkerton Academy. That's our game next week. Thanks for watching and a good night, everybody.
Major funding for the production of Granite State Challenge has been provided by Unitil, Energy for Life, NEA New Hampshire, with additional funding from D.F. Richard, Markham Image, Heinemann Publishing, Measured Progress, the NEEF Networks for College Planning, and by viewers like you. Thank you.